Hello everyone, you might have seen the news that Apple has recently open-sourced Swift's build system, and maybe you're wondering what's actually the impact for you as an app developer. It's a very good question, but also a bit of a technical one, so I figured why not make a video to talk about this topic. First thing, maybe let's talk a bit about what actually is a build system. So a build system is a piece of code that sits on top of the compiler and that basically orchestrates how your source files are going to be fed to the compiler. Typically, this means making sure that your source code is being built in an order that matches the dependencies between your modules. And it also means trying to schedule the compilation of the source code in a way that will maximize the potential to run compilations in parallel. So now you might be wondering, since the code of this build system is now available on GitHub, does this mean that you can build an iOS app without using Xcode or Xcode build? And so, for example, be able to build your app from a third-party IDE like Cursor, for example? Well, the answer to that question is no. And the reason is that the Swift build system is only a part of the full build system used by Xcode in order to build an iOS app. When you want to build an iOS app, yes, you need to build your Swift code, but you also need to do things like handling all of the assets, managing the entitlements, the code signatures, and all of these very complex and delicate things that only Xcode knows how to do, in part because it involves some proprietary steps that I don't think are yet open sourced by Apple, and that, to be honest, I don't think Apple will ever plan to open source because it's just too close to their core business. And actually, if you look on social media, you will see some people that have tried to build their iOS apps, so their Xcode projects, using this new Swift build tool. And as you can see, they found out that it's not possible because this tool only handles a portion of what it means to build a full app. However, if you're curious and you look inside the code of this Swift build system, you will find the code that allows this system to interface with Xcode, and you'll be able to see that it's done by implementing a specific Swift protocol. So at this point, you might be wondering, well, why does it matter that Apple has open sourced this Swift build system? And there are actually some very good reasons why it matters. The first one is that, as of today, there are two different build systems that exist and that coexist to build a Swift project. One is used inside Xcode, and that's the one that's just been open sourced, and the other one was only used when you were running Swift Package Manager by itself. And as I'm sure you already know, whenever you have two different pieces of software that are supposed to do the exact same job, you can be sure that there will always be some edge cases where they actually exhibit different behavior. So having the Swift build system used in Xcode open source will make it possible for this build system to be the one used everywhere on every platform. And that will play a big part in making sure that we have a healthy and reliable package ecosystem in which developers can be assured that their code will always be built the same way, regardless of the context in which it's being built. But another reason why this is a very exciting news, and this one is more on the long term, but since the code for the Swift build system is now open source, it means that developers in the community can have a look at it, better understand it, maybe be able to offer some suggestions in order to improve it, either by making some pull requests or just by sharing good practices so that developers are able to architecture their projects in a way that will better match how the Swift build systems operates under the hood. So to recap, this open sourcing by Apple of the Swift build system doesn't really have any immediate impact or consequences for you today as an app developer, but it's quite a good signal sent towards the healthiness of the Swift open source community on the long run. And who knows, maybe over the coming months, it will lead to some interesting contributions from the community. And don't forget, since this is now open source, it means that the full code is available on GitHub. You have the link in the description of the video. And I would recommend that maybe you spend 15 minutes, half an hour checking out the code. Of course, it's quite a technical piece of code, and I wouldn't expect myself to understand everything at first glance. But still, I think that having a look at this kind of a piece of code is still valuable, because even if you don't understand everything, there will still be one or two takeaways that you'll be leaving with. That's all for this video. I hope that you've enjoyed this new format where I try to talk about recent news. As always, whether you've liked it or not, please let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.